So the theme for this deck is HP Lovecraft. It's all based on Lovecraftian horror, and it just reeks, it drips of Lovecraft. I mean, if you guys don't know who that is, HP Lovecraft was an author from the 1920s who wrote stories such as The Call of Cthulhu, Dagon, and like At the Mountains of Madness. Recently, though, like, a bunch of his stories have been, like, slowly crawling into pop culture. I mean, you've seen Cthulhu in a few episodes of South Park, and you've seen, well, just recently, Guillermo del Toro was supposed to make a movie based on At the Mountains of Madness, which was written by H.P. Lovecraft. So, slowly, his stories are coming into pop culture. But anyway, this deck's all based on those stories, and it was really fun to put together. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, the deck's super, super budget. There's, like, nothing in here worth over a buck. So, I mean, it's really affordable. That's the best thing about theme decks. I mean, when you put the theme deck together, you're playing with cards that usually don't play anywhere else, even in EDH. I mean, an EDH is supposed to be the format where you play, like, almost any card. But with theme decks, you play the cards you won't even play with when you're building a EDH deck that you want to be decent or semi-good. I mean, it's fun to play. I'm not gonna lie, it's not very good. I mean, I think I've won one or two games with it, and those are just really lucky. I don't know. Like, no one was paying attention to me, and I was just able to swing with, like, a couple of the Eldrazi cards or Wrexial for a win or something, take two extra turns. But anyway, yeah, it was really fun to play. When you play it out, it's like playing a story. I mean, there's a lot of different themes that people have that I've seen. There's a few people that have, like, I don't know, a pirate theme or oozes, or even someone I've heard try to make it like an elephant deck or something like that. Some pretty crazy ideas. But anyway, let's get started with what I put together here. Like I said, it's all based on H.P. Lovecraft, so all of his stories. And for the general, I chose Wrexial, the Risen Deep. Now, the reason I chose him is because out of all the legends that I was looking at, he resembles Cthulhu the most. I mean, look at him. He's got, like, the octopus kind of head, kind, you know, even though he doesn't have the wings. I mean, he's coming out of water, like one of the deep ones, and I don't know, he just seems really Cthulhu-ish. And not only that, he has two colors, and blue-black is pretty good if you want to play, like, a Lovecraftian type of deck. But anyway, Wrexial, the Risen Deep is pretty sweet. He's a 6-mana 5/8 island walk and swamp walk, and whenever he deals damage to a player, you may cast target instant or sorcery from that player's graveyard for free, and then you exile the spell after you cast it. So, best case scenario is you swing in against someone that has either swamps or islands out, and you take, I don't know, like something that makes you take extra turns, or a tutor, or something sweet like that. But, yeah, anyway, he's pretty cool, and, yeah, let's get started.
Look into its eyes. It sees what we can't.
Okay, so for the creature base of the deck, it was pretty hilarious choosing. I mean, I chose a lot of, like, I don't know, horror-looking things. I mean, the first one here, Lorthos the Tidemaker, he's another card that I wanted to use for the for my general. But, I don't know, being mono-blue, the picks for the cards in the rest of the deck wouldn't be as flavorful, I thought, so I chose Wrexial instead. But anyway, I chose Lorthos. Maybe he's like Dagon or something, I don't know. But anyway, he's a 8-mana 8/8, and he's pretty cool too. I mean, he's a big beater. Like, usually he just dies to, like, any black removal spell when I bring him out, or I don't know. He usually doesn't hit the field, but if he does, it's a beating. Anyway, he's pretty cool. We have Dark Hatchling here. Not the greatest, but looks pretty sweet. Seem kind of H.P. Lovecraft-ish. Roiling Horror, again, not that great of a card, but, you know, he's kind of cool. Looks pretty sweet. Another horror here, Nihilith. I thought this guy was pretty cool. He, like, coming out from another dimension or something like that. I mean, you play him early, he comes out, he's a 4/4. I mean, you know, whatever. He has fear. That's kind of cool. Artisan of Kozilek, like I said, super budget, so, like, I'm not even using any of, like, the bigger Eldrazi, you know, Kozilek's not in here, and, neither is, well, Emrakul's banned, but Kozilek and Ulamog aren't in the deck. So I'm using Artisan of Kozilek. He's pretty cool. I mean, like, one of the two games that I won, I think I had Wrexial out and an Artisan of Kozilek in my hand, and I think I had Lorthos in the graveyard. I was playing against someone, like, two other people. One person was playing, like, red-green, and another person was playing a mono-blue deck, and the red-green guy had, like, an enchantment out that said all creatures have haste. So I had, like, 10 mana out, and my blue opponent was all tapped out, and I drew into Artisan Kozilek, and I saw I had Lorthos in the yard, and I was like, okay, this could work. So I cast Artisan, bring back Lorthos, swing, take a Time Warp, and I take an extra turn, and I swing at the other opponent. It was pretty much just game over after that, but that's really, really lucky. Like, no one was expecting me to do anything the whole game. I mean, I had Wrexial out and just using him as a blocker most of the time, but anyway, it was pretty cool. Next up, Pathrazor of Ulamog, again, another one of those cool Eldrazi. They look like, I don't know, something from another dimension. They're pretty big. Ulamog's Crusher, another cool one. Hand of Emrakul. Cyclopean Giant. I put this guy in here because when you read the stories, they describe the city that, like, the old ones are from, or the deep ones. It's called, like, Rillie, and they say that they're all, like, cyclopean buildings or something. I don't know. And that comes from, like, Greek mythology, where there's, like, these huge monuments or these huge buildings that are so gigantic and just so huge that no one but the Cyclops could have built it. But anyway, the reason I put the Cyclopean Giant in there is because the Cyclopean buildings in Rillie. Bloodright Invoker. Dread Drone, Withered Wretch, Blood Gift Demon, Necrotal, Thought Gorger, another one of those, like, horrors, Ludovic's Test Subject. There's other stories that H.P. Lovecraft has. There's one about a scientist, so I thought it was kind of cool to put Ludovic's Test Subject in. I mean, I've never really played with the card before, so I just wanted to try to put it in a deck and see if I can cast it. Hidden Horror. Deranged Assistant. Thought of Adele. Now, in the story Dagon, there's these, like, fish people, and they're all, like, protecting this, like, treasure or something like that, and this reminded me of that story a little bit, so I put that in there. Village Cannibals. Delver of Secrets, again, like the scientist guy. Undertaker. Hex Parasite. Onyx Mage. Zedek, Lord of Secrets. Guard Gumazoa. Ravenous Demon. Oops. Let's get that in there. Black Cat. Extractor Demon. And Sengir Autocrat. So a bunch of big creatures and some, like, deranged followers. Here we're going to go over our hand disruption suite. We have Hymn to Turok, which is pretty strong. We have a Duress. Mind Rot. And now we're going to go over our draw engines. Like, I put Book of Wrath in here because of, like, the Necronomicon. H.P. Lovecraft is the person that made up that book in one of his stories. So we have Book of Wrath, we have Mysteries of the Deep, Sea Beyond, Treasure Hunt, Fact or Fiction, Murmurs from Beyond, Necropotence, which is pretty cool. Deep Analysis. And now for our counter suite. I think most of them are pretty flavorful. I mean, Dash Hopes is pretty cool. It's a black counter, so that's pretty awesome. We have, Deprive. Hinder. I think the art looks sweet. Remove Soul. And let's go over our removal suite. We have Tragic Slip here. Brittle Effigy, And Brittle Effigy's in there because of, in the story Call of Cthulhu, there's a chapter called, like, Horror in Clay or something like that, and that reminded me of that. So Brittle Effigy's in there, and it's an okay card. Last Gasp. And Terror. And I put, like, a little Curse suite in here. I mean, we have Curse and Misfortunes, and, like, I think every other curse that's common or uncommon, in blue or black also. So we have Curse of Misfortunes, we have Curse of the Bloody Tome, which is cool because you can have your opponent mill their, like, instants and sorceries for Wrexial to cast. Curse of Thirst to do some damage to him. Curse of Oblivion. Curse of Death's Hold. Next, I'll go over, like, some of the fun cards. Increasing Ambition, it's kind of cool. It looks kind of, like, ritualistic, because in H.P. Lovecraft stories, there's a lot of people that are doing, like, rituals or whatever to please Cthulhu and stuff like that. Rite of Replication seemed kind of cool. I mean, I have to have some kind of win condition, right? Baneful Omen looks pretty sweet. Has a sweet-looking merfolk on there looking at who knows what, maybe his future. Brink of Madness, it just sounded kind of cool, because Cthulhu brings you to madness. Sadistic Sacrament, Call to the Netherworld, I think the name's really sweet, perfect for the deck. Sabo's Web, I like this card a lot. I even used it in one of my other EDH decks that I play a lot. I think I'm using it in Gerard right now, but anyway, when it comes into play, you get to draw a card and lands with activated abilities that don't produce mana, don't untap during their controller's untap step. So that's pretty sweet, especially in this deck where I'm running almost all basic lands, so it's really advantageous for me. It's like running a crappy Blood Moon, but anyway, we have Sabo's Web. Conspiracy, the name's pretty cool. I mean, it doesn't have that much interaction in the deck other than turning all my creatures into humans for my Ravenous Demon, but whatever. Tortured Existence to bring back my bigger creatures. Circle of Affliction, I thought that was pretty cool. And finally we have our one mana fixer, Prismatic Lens. But yeah, those are the non-creature spells. Next we'll go over the land base. Alright, now it's time for the land section of the deck. We're gonna show you guys, like, what we're running. I think I run only 34 basic, or 34 land, and most of them are basics. I think I only have, like, 4 non-basics, so let's take a look at what we're running. We have 1 Halimar Depths, Evolving Wilds, Dreadship Reef, mostly because it has Dread in its name, and a Barren Moor. And we're running, I think, 16 swamps, yeah, and 14 islands. So that was our Wrexial the Risen Deep Cthulhu Lovecraftian horror theme deck. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys liked the video. And I hope you guys are interested in making your own EDH theme decks. I mean, they're awesome to put together. They're really fun to play. And they're just crazy, insane, and wacky. But anyway, if you guys are interested in our contest that we're doing also, it's really easy to enter the contest. All you have to do is like this video, follow us on Twitter, and leave a comment on this video of your Twitter name, and we'll pick from those comments who won. And we'll post in the next video the winner of the contest. So stay tuned for that. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.